the 17-year-old from Moscow, Russia, Viktoria Volchkova, in eighth place after the short program, twice the European bronze medalist. And trying to move up here with her free skate.
And her movement over the ice has a great sense of freedom. She is opening with a triple lutz, double toe combination. She goes back for the tap. Wonderful spring to her jump. She makes it look so natural and easy.
Now watch the straight line entrance into this triple flip. Right here, the turn of the edge, the straight line. Wonderful height. Great spring. The loop jump, she just popped right out of that.
Viktoria, the third Russian here in the ladies' event, along with Irina Slutskaya and Maria Butyrskaya. She beat out Yulia Soldatova for a spot on the world team. Soldatova won the bronze medal at Worlds last season.
Nice triple salchow.
She really has a most impressive figure on the ice, very tall, and that combined with her jumping ability makes it a really superb combination.
Victoria was singled out by the French Ministry of Sport, which is part of the government here and has the right to drug test any athlete in the country. It's part of the reaction to the Tour de France scandal of a couple of years ago. And for quote-unquote erratic behavior, they chose to test Victoria. She was visibly shaken.
And I think that may have an effect on her during that short program.
Absolutely.
She's popping things here left and right, including that axel jump right there. Should have been a double. Look at how much flow she has over the ice. And again, see, these kind of mistakes really are a disaster for somebody in her position. She's poised on the threshold of becoming a champion. She has to prove better consistency than this.
It's been a difficult week with the issue that we brought up a little while ago and the drug testing by the Ministry of Sport, struggles in the short program, and now some more struggles here in the free skate. Viktoria Volchkova.
Her opening jump, this triple lutz, look at the height that she gets. It's wonderful, natural spring, and she is so straight in the air, really controlled, nice rhythm in between the triple lutz and double toe afterwards. A very strong beginning.
alongside her coach, Viktor Kudryavtsev, on the right, who used to coach Ilya Kulik and Maria Butyrskaya. Now the first set, Dick.
Well, you know, they're about right. The ladies simply cannot pop those jumps and fall upon them and expect to get better marks. But she just has such a marvelous physical potential. She looks spectacular on the ice, and you'd like to see it better than this. These marks are just not good enough for her. They're right, but they're not good enough.
Hey, figure skating's greatest pairs and dance teams will compete for the title of World's Best. Two-time world champions Berezhnaya and Sikhorodlidze shocked the skating world when they were forced to withdraw prior to the competition after Yelena failed a drug test at Europeans. But their absence has opened the door for a new set of contenders from the deepest pairs field in recent history. Shen and Zhao, the powerful Chinese pair, lead after the short program. They lost last year's title by just one judge's vote. This year, they could claim the first gold medal in pairs ever for China. Russians Petrova and Tikhonov trail close behind in second. This season, they've beaten every top pair except their missing teammates. It falls on their shoulders to continue the tradition of Russian dominance. And Canadian newcomers Salet and Pelletier, currently in third, are already being called the next legendary pair. Will they find a happy ending to their memorable love story program? In ice dance, the French team, Anacina and Pesera, bring an unmatched dramatic flair to their performances. They go for their first world title before a partisan home crowd. Plus, two American dance teams look to break through in Nice, national champs Lang and Chernyshev, along with emerging young stars Silverstein and Pekarik. The pairs and ice dancers go for world gold next.